Okay, so I think that we can start officially the tournament with the first game, beginner versus Arabian Knight.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Game is loading.
Okay, maybe
And
I'll need to check if everything is working. It looks like it's working for the viewers. And okay, I need to restart Cheat Engine. Okay, this time it works.
what was the hotkey? Okay.
Okay, so let's check
Do we
what's
have
going
Cheat
on.
Engine on right now?
Sorry?
Do we have Cheat Engine on?
Yes, 2 times the speed.
It looks pretty slow to me. Unless it doesn't work in my Cheat Engine. Let me check something.
Okay.
Oh. Okay, I gotta speed it up.
Okay, just tell me we can have a restart,
Yeah.
I
No, no,
guess.
no, don't restart, don't restart.
Okay.
Just run with it. Okay. We got Arabian Knight versus Beginner, both as the Saracens, because Arabian Knight picks Saracens, that's the only Sylph it's designed for. And its opponent has to go for Team Random, meaning it plays the same Sylph. So we have a 1v1 Saracen war on Arabia. And I already see Beginner started luring its deers already, very early, before 4 minutes, already luring deer. It has, look at Beginner's sheep. It has very good sheep control DOC already. Also luring its
Yes.
boars early. That is already a lot of Dark Age DOC.
That's right.
Maybe that boar maybe wasn't quite optimal because it didn't have enough villagers to shoot at it, so the boar is a bit behind the TC instead of under the TC. And the other boar isn't eaten yet. So not perfect there, but just the amount of DOC and especially the sheep management looks really good.
Yeah, that's crazy, in fact. What I know is beginner, Jacqueline worked a lot in its AI testing against the standard
Yeah.
DE AI, which is almost Promi.
It is Promi. It is
Yeah.
literally Promi. Just updated.
And so it was almost what we can call a benchmark for Jacqueline.
But
Did you
as far
pick
as I
Promi?
know, it is not really tested on AOC, the beginner AI, but it did have really good results on DE. If that translates into AOC, that would definitely be a very strong AI. And if it actually performs as well on AOC as it does on DE, then it could even make it to a very high placing in the tournament. So, looking right now, we have the economy equal from both AIs, both on 22, 23 pop right now. Beginners maybe a few seconds behind, maybe had a little bit of idle time on the TC. Both already had Loom early on. And both had. Okay. Arabian Knight is already making more farms. As I said earlier, the strategy for Arabian Knight. Oh, look at that!
Yes,
Arabian Knight's TC!
I did catch it. That's really
Beginner
nice from Blue, the
has a
scout.
really low HP villager. Arabian Knight Scout went in with the DOC to try to snipe the villager, but Arabian Knight garrisoned the TC real quick. The villager survived, and it almost took down Beginner Scout.
Yeah, that's already crazy. What we can notice is the fact that Arabian Knight doesn't get.
Oh! Another! It tried another villager snipe, and this time the villager fought back and one-shot the
Yeah.
scout because it was already so low. And that
Yeah.
is a bit of a misplay from Beginner. That DOC can definitely be adjusted. So it tried to go for some villager picks with its starting scout, but because the scout was so low
Who's that?
HP from running under the TC, it just lost the scout instead. Now Beginner is going up to the field edge, and I see some chat in some weird symbols no one can read, assumedly because it tries to write Chinese characters.
Yep.
But as you can see, Beginner up to field edge half a minute earlier, 2 villagers earlier than Arabian Knight, and Arabian Knight should go for a castle, for a fast castle. But looks like Beginner is also going for a fast castle with 29 villagers. That can't be a flush. It already built a barracks. It's a lot on wood. What's up with
Yep.
Beginner's eco balance? Beginner has No one. It has six farms. No one on farms. Only villagers on berries and a lot on wood.
Well, it goes for two archery range anyway, so it's
okay. Two archery ranges and a blacksmith immediately right off the bat. Mm-hmm. So it is a flush, but it's an extremely slow flush.
Yeah,
if you're gonna
right.
go for a flush, you shouldn't. At 29 villagers, it's extremely slow. Like 24 villagers is like default for AIs. Humans go much slower and faster with like 19, 20, 21 villagers. But 29 villagers is the slowest flush I've ever seen. And that's not, that might not be fast enough to stop the fast castle coming in from Arabian Knight. Arabian Knight is in feudal age. Oh, it's only getting now loom. It has a stable. It's only now making the blacksmith. So it didn't have enough wood to make the blacksmith earlier, maybe. So a beginner still has enough time here to come in here with his archers and do a lot of damage before Arabian Knight goes up to the castle edge.
Yes, that's exactly what we can hope. Well, the good part is the fact that blue goes for archers instead of skirmishers, so maybe he can kill some.
Definitely the right choice. Definitely the right choice against the fast castle. Skirmishers wouldn't have done much, but the archers have the much better potential to do economic damage. But you saw just right now, the archers were chasing the scout from Arabian Knight for just a few seconds, and there was enough to draw them away from the town of Arabian Knight. And now look at the archers. They're just attacking the barracks. They're not doing any damage.
Yeah, that's pretty sad.
I wouldn't be surprised if
beginner detected that its opponent is actually researching castle. I think it's added to the script.
Yeah, but so if it does, then it
can explain his behavior.
No, it doesn't. It's the worst behavior it could possibly do. It needs to get in there. It needs to kill all of the villagers on gold and stone. Look at all of these gold and stone villagers. That's the strategy of Arabian Knight. It goes to Castle Age. It abuses the Saracen market bonus to sell stone, buy food, I would assume, with that many villagers. It buys food, then just spams knights out. It's already Castle Age is making knights from two stables. There's such a strong economy right now because it doesn't have any food villagers. It just sells stone and gold for food. That's what makes the knights.
And the plus two defense, man.
Yeah, it already has the upgrades. And beginner just can't do the damage. It didn't. Those archers were stuck on the barracks. So there's definitely something wrong with the attack. Attack is the problem. Those archers should not be stuck on the first building they encounter. They need to go to the camps and kill villagers. That's what they need to do. So definitely room for improvement there.
It doesn't need to retreat the knight from the TC anyway. With the plus two defense, it's already pretty strong. And so many villagers are already falling.
This game is over.
Yeah.
This is not going the way I expected. It's just... Maybe beginner isn't made to deal with a fast castle, or maybe it's just that the attack isn't good enough. I don't know if that's a thing because it was made for DE and not for AOC, but it shouldn't work. That should not work differently, should it? Yeah. And it definitely scouted. Beginner definitely scouted the gold. Didn't spot the mining camp though, even though the mining camp is right there. So maybe it didn't know where the mining camp was, and that's why it didn't attack the mining camp, but it should have at least kept scouting with something. And just the fact that it didn't do any economic damage just threw the game away. And now then the game was pretty much over when it didn't do any economic damage. The archers were the right choice. They could have killed a lot of villagers. They just didn't find the right spot to attack. They kept getting stuck in the barracks. And that's how the game is very easily decided and too easy for Arabian Knight almost.
What I love is the two unique farms built by Arabian Knight in its town. All the food is booked with the gold.
Yeah. I don't know, can you check in open edge, can you check the market? The market sell and buy values. I don't know if you can.
I think that didn't work on a strategy to counter something related to the fast castle.
I think it had the right strategy, it just didn't have the attack. Just the attack method. The archers just didn't go to the right place, they were just getting stuck in the barrel. Needs to work on the specifics of the attack.
Can you tell me which two other AIs are in this group?
Let me check that real quick. We have in group I The Carnate and Scion.
Okay. Okay.
Like I said, this is the group of death.
Yes, exactly. This I know too.
Beginners not off to a good start. Already losing his first game. And you know what I'm seeing right now? What's the problem, beginner? What's the problem right now? It doesn't resign, mate. It doesn't
resign. Exactly, it doesn't resign. It's a lake.
It's a juggernaut syndrome. It's juggernaut syndrome.
Alright, I think that we can give the victory to Arabian Knight.
Yeah, it is.
There is no comeback possible here. 23,
absolutely.
23 kill and 100 lows already for beginner.
Ooh, yeah, this is over.
This
zero
is
military,
over.
14 economy. Man, I'm actually impressed. This strategy from Arabian Knight is so extreme. It's all in. I don't think it even made any villagers after it got to Castle Edge.
Yeah, probably not, in fact.
It stayed on 30 villagers and went all in on the knights and made so many knights. This is an extreme AI, okay?
Yeah, that's right.
Even it's even more extreme than I expected.
I remember another AI made by Zimax, which is... I don't remember the name, but it's an AI which go for a fast Imperial 23 or 24 minutes, which is made the same way, very excessive in its strategy.
Man, that is impressive. Impressive strategy. And this was an AI made for user patch 1.1, so it doesn't even have access to DLC or stuff like that. It's just regular TSA, I would guess.
Yeah.
Looks like TSA.
Okay, I forgot to put the score. Sorry about this guy. So we've got Arabian Knight 1-0 versus Beginner. The 4 versus 4 can be interesting. At least the first game was kind of disappointing. Despite good feeling at the beginning of the game,
I kind of have a feeling that it's gonna go exactly the same way. The flanks are gonna do the same. The pockets are gonna do the same. I suppose the interesting thing is beginner gonna be able to do more damage in the feudal age?
Yeah, it was kind of disappointing, in fact, to see all those archers just attacking the barrack. So let's go for the next game.
Oh, go! Did you use Arabian Knight in any of the previous Davis Cups?
I think the first one contained Arabian Knight, the season one. But anyway, this strategy has its limit against a pretty aggressive AI. Arabian Knight can't counter AV Feudal Age Rush.
And the other one would just be to defend and develop your own economy. But it didn't... Yeah, beginner just didn't do the damage. It tried to go for the flash, but it didn't do the damage.
Yeah.
Just because the attack wasn't good enough. The unit control.
Okay, so I'm ready to start the second game. I hope that it will be a bit more even this time.
Go for it, man. That was a very quick game.
Yeah, too quick, man, for a first game.
And by the way, the chat is saying that you should turn down your game sound. In game.
Oh, okay.
Capture age.
Okay, might be better now. Let's go for capture age. Okay, so what are gonna be the civilizations? Spanish, Saracen, Celt, and Aztec. Aztec is gonna be a flank.
So, yeah, we have a beginner in blue, red, green, and yellow on the bottom left side of the map with four different civs, only one Saracen this time. It also has Spanish, another cavalry civ. Then we have Celts in the pocket. That's gonna be, that could be extremely strong if it survives long enough. And obviously Aztecs in the flank. Aztecs in the flank is also extremely strong. I think Aztecs here are the best chance to do a lot of Feudal Age damage, especially.
Yeah, and they are very close. Red and Teal are close.
Yeah, red and Teal are close. That is very correct. And we can assume that all the Arabian Knights are gonna do exactly the same crazy aggressive Knight Rush that we saw the last game.
Mm-hmm.
From beginner though, I would hope. I mean, the Archer Rush is definitely the correct choice to counter the fast castle. Definitely the correct choice. It just needs to be pulled off better. It needs to go to Feudal Age a bit faster, and it needs to just use its units, not get stuck on the first building it sees.
Well, now I don't know if that strategy was chosen randomly or if it was chosen for a good reason.
I would assume that beginner has more than one strategy, but we're gonna see here. There are four beginners in this game, so there are four potential strategies that we can see.
Yeah.
And once again, we see from each of the beginners the great DOC in the Dark Age, luring boars, luring deers, and controlling the sheep. That's a really sexy DOC.
Well, I still don't understand why it was so slow in the game before to reach Feudal Age. Because
it went up on 29 villages.
Yeah.
I don't know why. It must have had the food much earlier than that.
Maybe it was a lake in dropping food in the TC, maybe?
I think it must have been a conscious choice. I can't explain it otherwise.
Look at Teal Lumber Camp. The Lumber Camp is definitely not in a good position.
For Arabian Knight T,
almost in the direction of the red player. And the Gold Mine can be a problem for Teal if it shows.
Oh, yeah, that's a terrible Lumber. Yeah, that Lumber Camp is very exposed. Yeah, I think it's going to go for the main gold and stone right in front. Then all its resources are forward, and that could be very easy to attack for red. Yes. I think this time red should do a lot of damage, and I hope it does.
Let's hope so, in fact.
Yeah, look at the food counts. We have two beginners up already, so now they're up on 24 and 25 top.
Okay, way better than the game before.
That's how it's supposed to be, but... and then green and blue, the pockets are obviously going to be later because they're going to go for a fast castle, I would assume. But yeah, at least the flanks. Okay, then maybe you're right. Maybe it was some kind of bug in the first game why beginner didn't go up earlier. And if Jacqueline, if you're watching this game, take a look at that first game. Take a look. Why didn't your AI go up earlier? And definitely take a look at that attack. Look at red.
Red, yes, a red player, two barracks.
Two barracks, man!
Let's see what's going on.
What is that? Why would it make two barracks? It's in Feudal Age, it's not making anything.
Yeah, I think that it's a strategy for Warlord Kingdom or DE with the Battle, which are spreading within Feudal Age.
Yeah, but it can't make Feudal Eagles. It's AOC, man! It's fucking AOC!
Well, you didn't adjust
your eyes! No!
It built a market, man, very fastly.
Yeah, I think you're right. I think it must have been Eagle Scouts. But it can't make Eagle Scouts in AOC! This is so stupid. Yeah, this AI is definitely not adjusted for AOC. That was the one concern I had, and it turned out to be true. On the other side, yellow. What's yellow doing? It's stable and blacksmith. It's scouts, I think.
Scouts. Oh yes. Look at purple, which is already losing two villagers.
I don't see it. Oh, in the TC. Okay.
Yeah, it lost two villagers close to the mill.
Purple isn't even a village yet.
Oh.
So yeah. Okay, that's working out. The fast scout rush from yellow is doing the damage. More scouts coming in here. If it can go in that lumber line and pick off more villagers, you shouldn't chase around the enemy scouts. You should go for the villagers, man. Go for the villagers.
That's funny to see orange and gray scouts
What are they doing?
The same position.
That's. Are they chasing each other? I don't know what that what the scouts are doing.
Yes, that's right. That's very weird. Okay.
Okay. Finally, yellow scouts on the lumber line.
Lumber camp. Yeah. Hurt a lot.
And the villagers are fighting back though, and the scouts, they don't have any upgrades. So the villagers can fight back, but they are now retreating.
Oh,
we lost like one or two, maybe two villagers. And the scouts, they cost a lot of idle time. All of the villagers have been pushed off of there. And a purple is up to the castle edge. But it lost a lot of idle time for the villagers. And that second lumber camp is in a really bad spot. That's a lot of walking time for those wood villagers.
Yeah, it looks like purple already lost 8 villagers. That's a lot, man.
And yeah, red really just a problem. I mean, red didn't take any damage because Tilo is also going past castle, but it's gonna be in castle edge right now. Red still has a minute to go until it reaches castle edge, and it still has no military. It's gonna be overrun by Tilo as soon as Tilo gets to castle edge.
Okay.
At least yellow is doing the damage on purple. That's the only reason why beginner has any chance of winning this game.
Exactly.
Because I'm pretty sure red is gonna die. I'm confident. Red is dead.
Look at blue, man. Blue goes for crossbows. As pockets. Sarazin.
Crossbow pockets? Crossbows. Not a great choice. I mean, obviously camels would be the perfect choice, yeah?
Yeah.
Beginner doesn't know that.
That's right.
Crossbows from the pockets are usually not a good choice just because they're so slow. They take a long time to arrive. But it is sending them forward. But now? Oh! The Arabian Knight is tripling that side! Orange, grey, and purple are all going to that side.
Yeah.
That should be more than enough knights to take down the early castle edge crossbows for blue. Look at how many knights there are already.
Yeah,
only 22 minutes. So many knights, they are already cleaning up the pocket blue crossbows. And there's just not enough crossbows to withstand that number of knights. And the scouts, I guess the scouts are fighting, but they're not making so much of a difference. On the other side, Teal should be attacking. It's only just now making some knights. And red still has no military. Can it not make... Red has nothing. It's making more TCs.
Yeah, booming, man. Just booming.
Yeah, I think it's still trying to make eagles. But it doesn't manage to make eagles, because they don't have the same IDs or the same unit lines. It doesn't work in AOC if you cook it for the E and don't adjust it. It's not made for AOC, it's just not working. Red has nothing!
Yeah, it is playing Spearman, man. Spearman, we've got some eagles anyway.
Oh, whoa. It has eagles, on the other side of the map,
yeah,
sorry.
It does. It's doing something.
They went to the other side of the map and still didn't get the thing. What's the problem with Teal? I think Teal is also bugging out. It must be.
Yeah, that's weird. I don't know why it's not attacking actually. What I remember now is the fact that in fact Jacqueline didn't work on good rules to detect the closest enemy. That's why it tends to attack the same guy.
Yeah, that's it. What's happening right now. All four of them are going toward purple. This shouldn't work, but it does. And it works because something is wrong with Teal. Teal didn't make many knights. Nonya has like 7 knights and they're already camping at its base, not attacking. It's not. Teal is actually going for more of an economy and not going aggressive. It went past castle and then 1 TC. What is Teal doing? I don't understand it.
Yeah, that's weird because when I see the resource gatherer.
Oh! Whoa. I have a theory that I need to share right now. My theory is the strategy for Arabian Knight, right?
Yeah.
You mine tons of gold. You mine tons of stone, and you sell them on the market, right?
Yeah.
That works in 1v1, but in 4v4, every single player's sales affect the market price. So they are selling at terrible prices right now.
Ooh,
that's what
yeah,
I think is going
yeah, on. That's right. 200 and almost 40 resources used to buy 100 food.
Yeah.
In fact, that's the problem for Arabian Knight.
So Arabian Knight really should only function perfectly in 1v1 then. Or if there's not more than one of this in a game, right? But now, Teal, Purple are counter-attacking on Blue. At least Blue has a defensive castle there, that's best. And the crossbow's coming from the back, supported by Spearman. fighting under the castle. That should be an easy defense here from blue. And but I do think they lost a lot of their military. Yeah, they have a lot of spearmen, unupgraded spearmen across the board. I see. From beginner. So look at the right side of the map. There's just villagers working right next to each other. Enemy villagers, not minding each other's business. And yeah, okay, looks like right now, I think at this point, beginner should win. Yeah, I didn't actually think about the market prices, man. The market prices are what screwed them over. Yeah, it works perfectly if there's only one in the game selling. But every player's sales affect the market prices. When there's four of you doing it, then obviously the prices are garbage.
Yeah.
Man, I really did not think about that. But
that's right.
That's an important factor, man. Yeah, that's why Arabian Knight cannot work, does it? It just doesn't work. And now, they're booming. The beginners are booming. Look at red. 125 villagers are ready. The highest Arabian Knight is 83.
Yeah.
So the booms are strong for beginner. At this point, it should be easy to close out the game. Just keep booming. It doesn't even have to defend that much because the Arabian Knights lost most of their knights. It's even attacking with some battering rams. Yeah, the battering rams are gonna go down a tier easy. But there's pikemen in there.
Yellow is doing a promi, man. Wow. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 TCs for yellow, actually.
6 TCs! 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 TCs!
Yeah! And 4 TCs for red, while Arrogant Knight stays with 1 TC each, man.
I'm having flashbacks, man. What was it? Was that Davis Cup 2? Davis Cup 3?
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I think it was Davis Cup 2. 5 TC promi group. That's a classic, dude. But 60 C boost from yellow, I mean Spanish, definitely. If you can pull it off, if you're not getting harassed, why not? You can get an extremely strong Imperial Age for Spanish, just go for the Paladins.
Well, I think that the economy balance is not great for yellow anyway, because 60 C when you've got almost 20 farms maybe.
Yeah, you know what I like though, from beginner? The armies, they're making pure pikemen. Because Arabian Knights making pure knights, what do you do as a counter? Pure pikemen! Don't even bother with anything else. Don't bother with cavalry, don't bother with archers or any other shit. Just make pure pikemen, that's perfect. And to back them up, the battle ramps to push down the town centers, and bam, that's the game.
And Grace yellow right is keeping trotting its opponent with now 8 TC, man, 8 TCs.
Is that a joke? How do you make 8 TCs? How is that possible?
Oh god.
Oh, it's trying to take a relic there. It ran through 2 TCs from yellow.
That's crazy.
8 TCs! Man, promi, you have a challenger. Not only is it making 8 TCs, it's winning with 8 TCs.
Oh god. What icon to pick for beginner now?
Tisantos, you got it right. I definitely like my gun. What do you say?
An HCC icon for the beginner, maybe?
Just. Whoa. Yeah. I mean, it doesn't even have that many villagers.
Yeah, that's rare.
Doesn't matter because Gray's already dead, Purple's dead. There's not really any. I don't see a reason why it made this ATCs except maybe just. Out of this pure disrespect, just
exactly,
to style on them.
Exactly.
Pure disrespect. It's an insult to the max, and it's an even bigger insult to promi. Just to see how that you can even win with 8 TCs. Promi couldn't win with 5 TCs? Yeah, just make 8, then you could win. And now, the entire army is here coming in. I mean, none of the beginners have been in Imperial Age. They have 44 minutes, and they are only now going up to Imperial Age. So they made massive Castle Age armies. With mainly pikemen, obviously, but also infantry and cavalry, and it's working.
Yeah, definitely.
And yeah, you know what this game came down to? It's the market economy. It's just a market economy. I think Arabian Knight must have been designed as a pure 1v1 AI.
Yeah.
In 1v1, it's insanely strong, but in 4v4, yeah, the market selling just doesn't work. It just doesn't. And at this point, you should probably resign. It's only Orange that's still alive.
Anyway, in 4v4, you can't stay with 1 TC only during the whole game. in a pocket, it's just impossible to win.
Okay.
Well, I think it's GG already.
Yeah, it's definitely GG.
Yeah.
So it's tied up at 1-1. Definitely looking much better. I think it. Maybe in the first game, beginner did have a bit of a bug or just a suboptimal attack. It should have won. It definitely threw that game. Here, right though, Arabian Knight just isn't suited for 4v4. That's what I take away from this game. Arabian Knight is a pure 1v1 AI.
Yeah.
Is what I believe.
Okay, let's leave the game because it looks like it will never resign.
Yeah, that was not a good trade deal. Trump would not approve, pro me, right?
Okay, guys. So we got the 2v2, which is coming.
The political jokes in the chat right now. Talking about trade deals, talking about Brexit.
Brexit, yeah.
Oh man, Brexit was just such a shit show, man. Brexit was obviously worse than American elections. And that says a lot.
Wait.
And you're still supposed to lower your in-game sounds, I'm told.
So, hello Armelon, I'm glad to see you around.
Armelon's in here?
Yeah.
Yeah, he is.
Don't forget to watch the VOD, Armelon. We've got a lot of stuff that you missed already.
And we're not done yet.
So, are you ready?
Yeah, I always am. So, for the last game in this three-game series, we have the 2v2
exactly.
Between Arabian Knight and the beginner. The promising newcomer versus the crazy old strategy.
Okay, what I love to watch is beginner at the start of the game. His Dark Age is crazy.
The Dark Age micro is so sexy.
Yeah, and the Scout Rush impressed me a lot, honestly.
Ooh, yeah.
It worked so well.
And we saw also in the first game just the attempt to harass with and pick off individual villagers with its starting scout. It didn't work in the first game. It lost its scout. But if Jacqueline keeps working on that, it could definitely be extremely annoying. Like we saw it already from Subjugator. Subjugator is also extremely annoying with its starting scout.
Okay, so are you in?
Yeah, I'm here.
Okay, perfect.
I'm watching.
So we've got Mongol. Okay, interesting. Red is Mongol. No excuse to fall the Dark Age. It should be fast. It needs to be fast.
It should especially have a very fast heal rate. And if it goes for archers again, then it should be very strong. And I think Mongols could also go for a scout rush. So maybe we're gonna see a double scout rush from beginner.
It's definitely what I want to see.
Then we can hopefully see some sexy DLC with the scout. And we know exactly what Arabian Knight's gonna do. It's just gonna go for the fast castle again, mine a ton of gold and stone, sell it at the market for food, and make knights from two stables.
What?
And we saw in the 4v4 that didn't work because market prices are affected by every player. And in the 1v1 it worked exceptionally well.
Exactly.
So let's see how it goes in the 2v2 then.
Yeah, it should be half as good as in 1v1.
Yeah, probably. But even the 1v1, beginner should have had a chance to win if just the archers would have done the damage, but they didn't.
Yeah.
So if you can, if it does a scout rush or even an archer rush and does the damage in feudal age, then beginner should still be favored in this match.
So beginner should attack the same guy once again.
Yes, Chisel Toast, that was indeed a compliment to Subjugator. Your scout is annoying as fuck. So, we have the... Okay, actually, I'm on... What's the hotkey? F2, yeah. I closed my open age and I'm in the standard game again. Because okay. I'm not used to it. And yeah, population 17, 18 villagers for everyone across the board except for blue. Blue is 2 villagers behind for some reason.
Oh, that's right.
I don't know why it had a slower start.
Yeah, it's
must
weird.
Have had some kind of problem.
It looks to be perfect.
Yeah, it can't be perfect. There's 2 less villagers than everyone else.
I think it's definitely because of a problem with the drop resources.
I think, maybe it doesn't drop resources enough to make the villagers. But what I also see almost every game so far is that the ball lures aren't perfect. Like, the boars always die outside of the TC. We saw it by blue. Look at the boar carcasses from blue. They are like 2 and 4 tiles in front of the TC.
Yeah,
they're not
right.
Under the TC, but they should be.
And maybe it lures the boars kind of too early, maybe.
Arabian Knight lost a scout at Blue's TC right now. And okay, and garrison again. Good.
I think that lure the boar too quickly can hurt the economy a bit.
Yeah, maybe it goes for the boar too early and doesn't have enough villagers to kill it fast enough.
Yeah,
maybe
that's
the problem.
Yeah.
And red is the first one up to fuel age. And is it already in fuel age? Maybe my overlay bugged out. Yeah, it wasn't fuel age. Oh, another bug from red. It made the blacksmith first before making archery ranges.
That's right. Yeah, and it's
great catching.
That's a problem.
That's so bad. It's a Mongol tool. It's the one that should be the fastest one. It went up on like 22 pop. Yeah, you have an extremely fast fuel age time. But what do you do with it? You don't build the archery range. You build the blacksmith first. What the fuck is that?
And one unique archery range is definitely not good.
Yeah, and now yellow and green have both clicked up. They're going for a fast castle. Blue is still in Dark Age. It's so far delayed. It's already 30 pop. Once again, 30 pop.
Oh.
And it doesn't even have any food. What are the villagers doing? How does that? Okay. Sorry, it did click up just late.
Yeah,
it did click up.
It did.
On 30 pop though. So once again, the 30 pop feudal age we saw in the first game. I don't know why it clicks up so late. I think you're right, it might be something with the food economy. I just don't know what. Jackie Lynn should definitely take a look at that, because that's also another bug that seems to be recurring. And red's still on a single archery range. It did make archers, it is sending the archers forward, and the archers are at the mill. They did force the villagers from green off of one lumber camp, but the rest of the economy from green is once again in the back.
Yeah, it's safe.
Lumber camp there in the back. We have the gold in the back. This main stone is going to be in the back too. And those archers are once again stuck on the forward buildings and not doing any damage. Now they're walking into TC at least. They're retreating and once again attacking house and mill. So once again, beginner not doing any damage. The fuel age attack needs to be improved. You cannot just sit in front of the base and attack buildings. That is not the point of archers. You need to kill villagers, man.
Yeah, and blue is coming on green too, as expected.
Yeah,
okay,
blue also with the archery ranges, with the late archer rush. Once again, much, much later than it should have been. So we expected scouts, turns out they went for archers. Archer's probably the better choice to deny a fast castle, but just if you don't do the damage. Yellow just now coming into castle age. It has 2 stables up. It does have a lot of villagers as we expect on gold and stone. It's not being harassed, it has to market, so it's buying food right now and it's starting to make knights.
For some reason, Yellow is building a third lumber mining camp very close from the blue town. I don't know why.
Right there! Yeah, that doesn't make any sense. I don't know why you build that there.
Yeah.
There's much closer golds to it. Maybe it didn't spot enough. But yeah, the archers from red and blue are doing... They're not really doing the damage, that's the thing. The green has both of its stables in the back, it has all of its economy in the back. The archers are still just attacking houses, okay? It's killing a few villagers now that are coming forward to try to build something. So at least they're doing some damage, but just because green is throwing away villagers, not because they're looking for it.
Yeah, green is trying to build the to build something just at that position attacked by Artis.
So this game seems still pretty open. There's still a good number of archers left alive. We have Red finally up the castle edge, so it can upgrade his archers to crossbows as soon as it gets there if it doesn't lose them. But here comes the deciding attack from Yellow. Yellow and Blue. Blue is completely undefended. That is like 9-10 knights. Right into, they go right into the TC. Maybe that's not optimal. They're attacking the TC. There are a few archers, a few screaming here to defend. Fighting under the TC fire. This should be a good fight for Blue, at least the best it can get under the circumstances. If the knights would like go to the back mill, for example, or to the lumber camp, they would do a lot more damage, but they're just right to the TC right now. And the economy, if Yellow doesn't do the deciding damage right now, then the economy is gonna go so heavily into the favor of Beginner.
Okay, I decrease the sound of the game. Okay. And let's go back to Capture Rage. Okay. Oh, Red is coming to help Blue.
I mean, it looks like Yellow was able to do damage, but once again, looking at the villager numbers, it really did not. Because Arabian Knight doesn't make more villagers, and Beginner does. Arabian Knight has like half of the villagers on this team. Here comes the army, archers, they're not upgraded yet. Crossbow upgrade finished right now. A lot of spearmen there as well. Blue is now also in Castle Age. This red army can just do the damage wherever it goes now, because spearmen and crossbows is just the perfect counter tonight.
Exactly. The game definitely can be interesting just to the end, because it can turn in a 1v1. Look at green, which is hurt a lot. While blue is effectively...
Oh, the blue TC just went down. Yellow just kept making the... I don't think it's enough. Even if blue goes down here, I think red can 1v2 this.
Yeah,
I think red can 1v2. Because look at the population. Red's already over. Red has more population than green and yellow combined.
And blue resigned, man. It resigned. It didn't. It did have some villagers.
It had 9 villagers left. How would you resign?
Yeah, it shouldn't have resigned.
No, that is not good, man.
Like
in the first game, when you resigned. Okay, beginner, Jacqueline, your resign rules please fucking work, man. In only one when you've lost, you resign. Okay, there's nothing you can do. But this is a team game. It shows a 2v2, but it's still a team game. You have 9 villagers left alive. You can run your villagers away, build a TC somewhere else, just rebuild while your teammate is carrying the game, which it is right now. You should never resign.
Oh man. Red was building one castle with one unique villager. It was the target of the yellow player. That's a lot.
But that's not even something that Arabian Knight did. That's just the fault of Beginner because of design. It shouldn't have resigned there.
Yeah,
just threw the game away. This is like a brute force resign from FCT7 or some shit. Just throwing the game just for got a random resign.
I think that now Red needs more and more TCs. Definitely.
No.
It needs 8 or 10 TCs maybe. To survive
Red
in
lost
this
most
1v2.
Yeah, Red lost most of its army. If Yellow and Green just keep making... The thing is though... At least Yellow and Green, the Arabian Knights, they did finally switch to a farm economy. So they're not just mining anymore and selling it. They're actually farming food, so that's good. Because market prices are... I would assume market prices are garbage by now.
Yeah, it's a good reaction. Okay, but let's check what's going on with Red, which is actually attacking. I'm upset to see that one unique villager is building a castle, especially when it's in the front of the town from Red.
Should be more villagers in there.
Definitely. Red needs to kill Green fastly now.
Yeah, it really does, because if it doesn't, then knight numbers can overwhelm it. But just in pure villager numbers, Red... I think Yellow and Green are gonna outperform. It's like the main weakness right now of Arabian Knight is that it sticks with its very one-dimensional army composition of knights, and more knights. And that's just so easily countered by spearmen. I mean, the spearmen aren't even upgraded to pikemen, but they're still doing the work. So even though red is 1v2 and doesn't have more villagers than both of them combined, it does have the army to counter the knights.
Okay, yellow is back from on the red economy, but red has 4 TCs now.
Ooh, 4 TCs, once again, making a ton of TCs, but I don't think it has enough of a food input to...
Yeah, it has no food.
Yeah, exactly. It doesn't have any food.
Doesn't have nearly enough food to sustain villager production, so it makes too many TCs for no reason, really.
Oh, yellow is actually spamming a lot of knights coming from
red.
Two stables.
Yeah,
three stables non-stop.
So these knights are attacking the castle, and red does have researched the, what's it called, murder holes. So the castle can shoot the knights right under it.
Yeah,
so those knights
point.
Are still going down. And yellow is still booming pretty strong, but so is red. I think that they are all still making good economy, and if it keeps going, I don't think red can win unless it does something besides them. Yeah, there's so much idle economy here. Those villagers are trying to go to the forward lumber camp, keep getting pushed off. Yes, it does have the castle there to defend. Yes, it does have the spearmen to counter the knights. It even makes camels.
Yeah, camels is exactly what I wanted to see from Mongol. And this castle is so important, man. That castle is
It's 1v2. Yeah. This castle is extremely precious, you're right, but it's the longer the game goes on, it's still 1v2. It's 1v2, you gotta kill someone.
Exactly.
You gotta kill him quick.
Exactly.
I mean, it's at least good that green and yellow keep throwing their armies away, but if red can't take advantage and just do something, red needs to defend, it needs to take the advantage. It's killing a knight trying to take a relic, and now it's in front of green space. I hope it does some damage finally. Doesn't look like it though. This army keeps getting distracted. Yeah, the army keeps getting distracted by single units that are chasing knights across the map. I think red, if red is able to do decisive economic damage to green right here, it does have a chance to come back.
Yeah, it needs rams at least. It does have one siege workshop, but I don't see any ram actually.
Yellow is still taking the gold from blue's base, so that's definitely BM, but also the red choice. Does Arabian Knight ever go imp? That's a good question in Mifo. I don't think we saw it on the 4v4.
Well, so, the economy balance of the yellow player is really bad. 3,000 wood, no food, no gold actually.
Yeah, that is terrible eco balance.
But red is really far from researching Imperial Age.
And it's also the red and yellow and green are both on 1 TC. They don't make more TCs, they don't make more farms.
Yeah. This is really
so
weak.
Red. Yeah, red is still a good chance, 1v2, even though blue resigned from.
Okay.
And right now it is doing the damage on green.
Yeah, green is gonna die soon, no?
Yeah, but still. It's the... what do I call... oh, it's the tribal syndrome, of course, the tribal syndrome! I was wondering what I was calling it, but it's tribal syndrome. No battery ram.
Well, it was an old syndrome for tribal, because now it does.
Yeah,
it does
now
make
it does.
Ramps.
As soon as you made it to make battery ram, tribal actually became really good. But we see here beginner mistake. Aptly named, it does not have the siege to take down the town.
Yeah. does red have relics? It doesn't have any monastery, it looks like. Okay,
that's
also
a
problem.
What we saw in the 4v4, also, Arabian Knight was going for the relics, beginner wasn't. But as long as there's gold on the map, it shouldn't make a difference. But that's definitely something that you should add. Also, Jacqueline. AI looks pretty promising, but there's still so many things that need to be improved. But there are obvious improvements, like, those are things that he should see in his test. And if he does improve these things, then this AI could be top tier.
That's crazy, because yellow is attacking red, while red is attacking yellow's economy.
Yeah, red is fighting everywhere on the map right now.
Yeah.
And it's still, yeah, you see still, Arabian Knight is so stubborn, it only makes one unit the entire game, it only makes knights. And it's just so easy to counter.
Yeah,
I don't know why Red,
Red
still hasn't upgraded his spearman to pikes.
Yeah,
he still doesn't have the pikeman upgrade, that's a problem.
Okay, no.
Just get the upgrade, man. DOS, bro, get the pikeman upgrade in such an extreme situation. At least you're making spearmen, at least you're making camels, that's good. But upgrade them, please. Upgrade.
Yeah, because the plus one spearman is really poor. Plus one attack for spearmen only.
I mean, the upgrades for this, the attack and defense upgrades don't really matter. It's the pikeman upgrade that's important.
Yeah, definitely.
The pikeman upgrade is the one that gives the bonus damage.
Out! I'm curious to see beginner playing as Turkish. If he trains a lot of spearmen too.
Yeah, I think the light cavalry would be good for Turkish at least. But yeah, the spearmen aren't great. It's playing like it's Turk. It's just not upgrading. It thinks it doesn't have the elite up. The pikeman. But yeah, Red still holding on. It's now up to 100 kills. 100 civilian population. 100 villagers. And I think Red can pull it back. Just needs to upgrade it. It needs to go to imp, but needs to upgrade its spearman at some point. It's now getting husbandry.
Well,
yeah, come on, man. You need the upgrades. You need the pikeman upgrade. You need the imperial age. And then you're gonna win this game. Because I think at this point it's almost impossible for Red to lose. Because even Gallo just didn't do the damage, and they keep sticking with their one soul strategy. They make it pure knight, and pure knight that does long term to the counter.
Pikeman, eventually research.
Oh, finally! Look at how fast an upgrade is going. It's like, imagine if Red had gotten an upgrade like 20 minutes ago, the game would probably already be over.
That's
we already won. We have 1 hour into the game and no one is in serious.
Okay, let me check something.
You're pausing the game, by the way, when you check something.
Yeah. For some reason, I put the sound down, and when I come back to the capture age, the sound is growing once again. I don't know why.
Yeah, and obviously, and the worst thing, yeah, the tribal syndrome keeps on continuing. I still have Red doesn't even have. Okay, it does have a siege workshop. I don't think I've seen a single battering ram though.
Yeah.
Yellow is making battering rams. But Red isn't. Red needs the battering rams. You need battering rams or you need to go to fucking Imperial Age already and make some trebuchet. Either or, it's fine. But Red doesn't have the gold. Look at where Red is mining its gold. It's mining the gold right next to the castle. There's no mining camp there.
Yeah, so far from the mining camp.
There's no mining. Yeah, no wonder it doesn't have any gold. You need to make mining camps there.
Yeah, that's right.
And that's more obvious,
the right
that's
of
obvious
the map,
bugs.
It's the same.
Obvious problems. It doesn't make enough mining camps. Like that, I could make a list right now of things that are easy to fix but big problems. And if Jackie Lynn just fixes those few things, then this AI would stomp this game. But look at the army. Look at how big the army is from Red. It's a pop cap right now. It's pop cap.
Yeah, pop cap. Yeah, 78 military population.
Maybe now it finally gets enough resources stockpiled because it doesn't make more units because it's pop cap. Look at it has already 1,200 food, but still only 200 gold.
Yeah.
If it ever gets enough gold to go to Imperial Age, this game is over, but until then, I don't know. It's kind of a stalemate, but it's still winning.
And
yeah,
it's
actually,
researching
yeah,
Guitar Age, actually. We can expect maybe some trebuchets.
I think it sold a bunch of stuff, but now, yeah. And it killed green, it killed off the green economy, it killed a bit of the yellow economy, so you're not actually ending up doing it.
One run, man. One run.
Yeah.
I found it.
Whoa. Oh, I see it! It's a green space, it's killing farms!
Yay! It's definitely coming, man. Do the job. I like the way it is isolated, man. It's all alone.
It's just BM delaying the game.
So far from the main unit, the main military unit.
Doesn't matter, won the game, 1v2. Even though Blue did a stupid design, even though Blue had a shitty Dark Age, even though it didn't upgrade Spearmen, even though it didn't make enough mining camps, even though it took way too long to go to Imperial, even though it didn't make any siege in Castle Age, it still won the game 1v2. That is impressive.
Oh man, how many TCs is Red building actually? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, man! 10 TCs,
it's
man!
It's many TCs all over the map! It's now full BM, it's full BM mode!
That's crazy.
And now Arabian Knight does. Now Arabian Knight does have the Juggernaut syndrome.
Okay, green is definitely dead now.
Yeah.
Zero population for green.
I gotta tell you, I am not disappointed with this game. This delivered exactly what I wanted it to.
Exactly.
I saw the promise from beginner, I saw the bugs from beginner that are easy to fix but are obvious and that can be fixed with just a week or two more of work just to fix these specific things. I outlined them, there's like a lot of them. Sure, there's a lot of problems, but they can be easily fixed. Jacqueline fixes them and bam, beginner's a great AI.
Exactly.
Meanwhile, Arabian Knight, the extreme strategy. So one-dimensional but so strong when it works in the 1v1 at least. This game delivered everything I expected from it.
Yeah, it was a very great game to watch. That's 3 vs 2. And the full population. No spot for any trebuchet now.
Yeah, okay, we're down to 10 population for the entire Arabian Knight team, so we probably screwed the game.
And look at this man, one on the ram, but it is a siege ram.
It's the hero siege ram. You don't need more than one if you already won. Just PM to delay it even more. GG.
Okay, the Persian tactic is researched, but we don't see any arbalest actually.
No, that's not the arbalist, that's for cavalry archers, man.
Yeah, that's right, but Elite Mangudai is missing too.
Yeah. It's at least making Mangudai. I mean, it would make more of that if it had the population space, but it's not using units anymore to pop that.
Oh man, did you see that? Okay, I don't remember the name in English. I call it a Bomberman, but I don't remember the name. He made a Bomberman, man. He's from the castle.
Yeah, a petard.
Yeah, a petard, man. He made a petard. So he doesn't train any trebuchets, he trained one ram and he trained one petard, man. That's crazy.
I gotta say, I'm already a fan of beginner. I'm a huge fan. This match convinced me. Sure, there are bugs, there are a lot of problems, they are obvious to spot and they should be easy to fix. And if Jacqueline fixes them, this AI, I hope, I really hope. I don't know if Jacqueline's, I would assume he isn't watching. I don't think he even speaks English. He literally uses Google Translator to translate from English to Chinese to talk to us. But if you speak English, if you're watching this, you know exactly what you gotta do. And I know that your AI is gonna be amazing by the end of this tournament.
Yeah, great. Okay, so I think that we can consider that Arabian Knight lost that game.
Yeah, G fucking G.
Only one stable is here. Okay. So, game is over now. Let's check. Okay. The statistic of the game. Well, it clearly dominated its opponent in late game, 85 military population, while yellow had at its top 32 and green 16.
Are you pinging me, man? Live. It's Esty that's streaming.
Okay, so we can release update the bracket.
Yes, you can.
You can.
I can, okay. That is Arabian Knight is okay, okay, I know how to do it. So we have Group I. AI player 2 is Arabian Knight. Arabian Knight. Oh man, your fields are always too small. I always gotta increase the size of the fields just to fit the name in there. And 3 is beginner. Blah blah blah, beginner. And we have a 1-2 scoreline.
Exactly.
Beginner already going off to a very prodigious start. And I hope we're gonna see more of the same. It's gonna be probably an even bigger challenge against the Carnate and Cyan.
Yeah, that's right.
Actually hope he watches this game and hope he's gonna update his AI before we do the other game. Because I want beginner to go to the final stages of this.
Definitely, yeah. But anyway, we can catch him easily in the forums.
And on Discord, obviously. He just needs to put on his Google Translator to understand what we're saying. Anyway, great game. Thanks you all for watching. I don't know if SD wants to say a few more things, but I gotta back out right now. I got a few other things to do.
Yep.
Definitely a lot of fun casting this one. And I'm definitely gonna try to do some more casts, even with someone like Rubberman or Life, some of the older AIs, because they know those AIs and they know their own AIs. So if I can do a stream together with those two or one of them, then it would be amazing. But just for now, peace out, guys.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you. Let's finish up the screen, and I hope you're gonna enjoy the rest of the tournament. Peace.
Okay, ciao, Alef. Thank you for being casted with me. And as I said before, I've got something to show you for the end of the first day of the Davis Cup Season 5. So I say you bye bye.